Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, you will learn how to bind ExpandoObject and DynamicObject to Syncfusion Blazor Kanban Component. Here, I'm going to continue with my existing Blazor WebAssembly example. If you want to know how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add Syncfusion components to it, check the video linked in the above card. You can also find its reference link in the description below. Now, I'll proceed to show you the steps to bind data to the Blazor Kanban component using ExpandoObject binding. Before moving to the coding part, let me explain what an ExpandoObject is. An ExpandoObject is basically a dynamic object that grows when you add members at runtime. In this WebAssembly app, I've already added the basic rendering code for the Blazor Kanban component. I've also bound task details to the data source property to show software development work in progress. Here, you will notice that the four fields ID, status, summary, and assignee are already defined in the task model class, and it acts as a data source type for Blazor Kanban. To bind dynamic properties at runtime without defining the model class, I need to use ExpandoObject binding. Here, to use ExpandoObject class, let me first remove the model class task and its reference from the Kanban component. When using data source as IEnumerable object, component type, tValue, will be inferred from its value. So, I will remove the tValue property. Then, I import the namespace, system.dynamic. And then change the task details list type to ExpandoObject, that by default changes the data source type to ExpandoObject. Next, I need to create a dynamic instance for the ExpandoObject class, so within this onInitialized method, declare a variable object of type dynamic and initialize the ExpandoObject. Now, using this dynamic instance, I'll generate a dynamic object and return it. Then cast this enumerable list to the ExpandoObject type. Here, I have constructed the ID, status, summary, and assignee fields dynamically without the model class. Note that these dynamic fields were mapped onto the Kanban component. Look at the output page now. The Blazor Kanban component is displayed with dynamic data. Now, let me proceed to show you the steps to bind dynamic object as data source for Blazor Kanban component. The dynamic object allows you to implement your own types with unique dynamic behaviors. I cannot directly create an instance of the dynamic object class. To implement the dynamic behavior, you have to inherit from the dynamic object class and override these three methods: tryGetMember, trySetMember, and getDynamicMemberNames. So as a first step, I define the dynamic dictionary class and inherit the base class dynamic object. Then, within this class, define a variable, task dictionary, of type dictionary to store key pair value of the dynamic properties. Next, I'm going to override two methods, tryGetMember and trySetMember, to specify dynamic operations on the properties. To begin with, I'll override the tryGetMember method, as this method will be called if we try to get the value of property that is not defined. Within this method, I get the value of dynamic property through binder argument and assign it to the string variable called name. Then, return this variable name to the task dictionary using the tryGetValue method. Here, it returns true if the property is found in the task dictionary or else it returns false. Next, I'll override the trySetMember method. This method will be called if we try to set the value of property that is not defined. Within this trySetMember method, I set the value of an undefined property. So, I'll assign this object value to an undefined property in task dictionary, and it returns true. And then, I need to override the getDynamicMemberNames method to return the dynamic property names to perform data operations and editing. Next, change this task details list type to dynamic dictionary and do the same for the onInitialized method. Look at the output page now. You can see the Kanban component rendered with dynamic object data. Here, you can perform all kinds of supported data operations and editing using ExpandoObject and DynamicObject. Now, let me summarize what we have seen so far. In this video, I showed you how to bind ExpandoObject and DynamicObject to the Blazor Kanban component. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also grab a free license key to use our Blazor products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.